Hello friends, it's IT Noyan from technotechforyou.com.
Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to discuss cellular radio network. Let's go start our discussion. At first we see the introduction. A cellular network is a radio network distributed over land through cells, where each cell includes a fixed location transceiver known as base station. Cellular radio network. In this slide, we show about the cellular radio network through the figure. In this figure, you see that the cellular radio network architecture. In this figure, we see that the different mobile users are connected to BTS, more BTS are connected to BSC, and the BSC are connected to MSC. In our next slide, we will discuss about everything about this structure. Let's go discuss about everything, but at first, you have to focus this graph and remember everything, every position. Now, let's go. Cellular radio network architecture. Here MS means mobile station, BSS means base station subsystem, and NSS means network switching subsystem. Let's see about the system architecture of mobile station MS. The mobile station is made up of two entities. First is mobile equipment. The mobile equipment is portable handheld device uniquely identified by an IMEI, that means International Mobile Equipment Identity. Its voice and data transmission, monitoring power and signal quality of surrounding cells for optimum handover. The second portion is subscriber identity module, that we call SIM, S-I-M. SIM card carries the user identity for accessing the network and receiving calls. All calls are changed against SIM card account. It is equipped with a memory to store telephone numbers along with names. It also enables to send and receive short messages, that means SMS. System architecture base station subsystem, that means BSS. Base station subsystem is composed of two parts. The first part is base transceiver station, that is BTS. It is consist of amplifiers, antennas, and relay radio masses, transceivers, that means PTRX. And the second portion is base station controller, BSC. It's allocation of radio channel, control handover from BTS to BTS. Now we see the architecture of network switching subsystem, that means NSS, Mobile Switching Center, MSC, heart of the network. Manage communication between GSM and other networks, call setup function and basic switching, call routing, billing information and collection, mobility management, that is registration, location uploading, inter BSS and inter MSC called handoff. Now we see the system architecture of network switching subsystem. Included home location register, that's mean HLR. The HLR is home location register. What is this? This is a permanent database about mobile subscriber in a large service area, generally one per GSM network operator. And database contain IMSI, prepaid, postpaid, roaming, restriction, supplementary service. And the VLR means visitor location register. it is a temporary database which updates whenever new MS enters its area by HLR database. Control those mobiles roaming in its area reduce number of queries to HLR. And EIR means Equipment Identity Register. That is, Equipment Identity Register is a database that contains a list of all valid mobile equipment on the network. And AUC, that means Authentication Center, it is a each network SIM card is assigned an individual authentication key for security to ensure that third parties are unable to use network subscriber services. In this slide, we see a figure that is the SMSC, Short Message Service Center. How the Short Message Service Center work, we see in this figure. This is a person, SP1, SP2. The SP1 person send a SMS to SP2. How this message is transfer? First message go to BTS, then BSC, then MSC, then SMSC, then the similar way MSC to BSC, then BTS, and finally handover to SP2. This is the process of Short Message Service Center. Dear viewers, thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe this channel and like the video. Bye bye.
Please subscribe our channel and click on the bell icon.